Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie-Lefurgey. Hearing loss can be caused by any number of things. Anything from illness to head injury to listening to music too loudly can result in some sort of deafness. Roughly 20% of Americans report some degree of hearing loss. However, despite the prevalence of deafness of varying degrees, a significant portion of the population doesn't quite understand how deafness works. Does life become a vacuum completely devoid of sound, or can certain things be heard? Let's explore. If you want more science videos, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, what do deaf people hear? Before jumping into the answer, there are some misconceptions about deafness that might be best put to bed. Many people believe that it is more politically correct to refer to deaf people as hearing impaired. While their hearts may be in the right place, this is actually not the preference of the majority of deaf people. Most deaf people prefer not to view their deafness as an impairment, but rather a part of who they are. This is an idea that's prevalent in deaf culture, but hasn't quite made its way into the mainstream. So if you're not sure how to refer to someone, first of all, you can just ask, but when in doubt, deaf seems to be the safer bet. Okay, with that out of the way, what do deaf people hear? Well, it all depends on the level of deafness in each individual. Hearing loss can be defined as a sudden or gradual decrease in how well one can hear. There are four different classifications of hearing loss: mild, moderate, severe, and profound. Each of these can be caused by a number of factors, and each can perceive different amounts of sound. That is to say, if you want to know what a deaf person can hear, you need to know just how much of their hearing they have lost. Individuals with mild hearing loss are able to hear sounds as low as 25 to 40 decibels, with each individual having slightly different thresholds for hearing. This is the level that would be considered hard of hearing in common parlance. These people can generally go about their lives more or less unaffected, although they may have trouble picking up softer sounds. Conversation can sometimes be difficult to understand, particularly if there is a lot of noise in their surroundings interfering with the conversation. This becomes more common as we age, due both to hearing loud noises over the course of one's life, as well as certain medical issues that affect the hearing. With these people, a hearing aid can generally allow them to hear sounds of any level. Moving on, those with moderate hearing loss generally can't hear anything below 40 to 70 decibels. This can cause significantly more problems than mild hearing loss. Someone who could hear down to 40 decibels wouldn't be able to hear birds chirping or low ambient noise, but if it was on the severe side of moderate, they could have some trouble hearing normal conversation or even music playing in the same room. Since increasing a sound by 6 to 10 decibels effectively doubles our perception of its loudness, there is a huge difference between those who can hear down to 40 and those who can only hear down to 70 decibels. However, those with moderate hearing loss can see great improvement with the use of a hearing aid. Moving on to severe hearing loss, this is where it becomes seriously debilitating. Those with severe hearing loss have a very high threshold for sound, needing a sound to be at least 70 to 95 decibels to hear it. Again, this threshold varies from person to person. Those who can hear down to 70 decibels can still get by with a regular hearing aid, but those with a threshold of 95 decibels would need a powerful hearing aid to hear most things. Someone on the high end of severe hearing loss could have trouble hearing a motorcycle from 25 feet away, often depending on lip reading or sign language to communicate. This is the level of hearing loss that is generally required in order to receive disability benefits, although the rules vary from country to country. Finally, we have profound hearing loss. People in this group vary in the profundity of the loss, with some able to hear some very loud noises above 95 decibels, while others hear nothing at all. Even those on the low end of profound hearing loss could have trouble hearing anything in a loud nightclub. Others are unable to hear anything at all, regardless of the volume. This is by far the rarest form of hearing loss, with roughly 0.2% of Americans being unable to hear anything out of both ears. Until recently, profound hearing loss wasn't very treatable. Those with this type of deafness depended on sign language and/or lip reading to get by. There have, however, been some exciting improvements in hearing aid technology recently, to the point where some individuals who are otherwise completely deaf are able to hear with the help of advanced hearing aids. There are some heart-wrenching videos of this on YouTube. They're a great watch, but definitely do so in private, where you won't be embarrassed when you become a sobbing mess. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. And if you still have more science questions, definitely check out the Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie-Lefurgey with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.